Hi there, everyone. My name is Chad, and today I'm going to be using component properties to update our library and make the components a bit more clear, flexible, and self-documenting in a way. You may have already started to use component props to reduce how many different variants need to be maintained for the consumers of your library, while also aligning them a bit closer to code. Here in our library, we've already added some properties to our button component set. And if we take a look at an instance with the icon enabled here, when using the instance swap property, you can see that we have a lot of icons to choose from. In our system, there's only about a half dozen of these icons that should really be used and are supported in the component. And I'd like to make it easier to understand which icons are the ones intended to be used. To do this, I'm going to select our button component set and edit the instance swap property. Here I can set some preferred values for that icon. So I'm going to go ahead and select the add icon as well as the remove. And we'll also add in our favorite icon. Now we have some preferred values for that instance swap. So when someone goes to use an instance of the button with an icon and uses the instance swap property, they can very, very quickly see which are the preferred options and what is really intended to be used. Now, if there are cases where something's not a preferred value and it needs to be used, we can still go ahead and select or search across any enabled libraries or even swap in a local component. Let's take a look at another component where we use instances of this button within it, our product card. In this instance, we can use props to edit the card content. But when it comes to our action buttons, we have to click down into them and make our changes. To make this editing experience smoother, I'm going to select the component. And when I go to create a property, I can expose the properties from those nested button instances. By doing this, now when someone uses the card component, they can quickly update the actions right from the properties panel. Let's update this favorite button to include an icon, and we'll add in that favorite icon we set as preferred. By combining variants and component properties at the library level, you can easily create some powerful components for the users of your system. To learn more about getting started with props, check out the link in the description to grab the component properties playground file from the Figma community. Also, let us know how you're using props in your libraries, and I'll see you next time.